everyone, I'm the Gaming Beaver, and welcome back to another episode 251, I think it is, of Jurassic World the game. Hold on, let me just adjust you guys. I'm gonna get really close while I just adjust this microphone. You like me being this close? I like being this close. I like you very loud. So, I just want to say before we start, I have been waiting for something to happen in this game for a while. That's why I haven't recorded much, because that really hasn't. I mean, there was some card packs, but I'm not really fussed. I've been saving up. We're now on 600,000 DNA. But before I get into anything, I just want to say, oh my god, guys. You have killed it. The thing is dead. I said in episode 249, where it was like Omega Returns, and it's like the big Indominus Omega Versus thumbnail that loads of you guys liked, and I like had that idea. I was like, that'd be really good. Let's make a purple Versus and everything. Anyway, in that video, I said, can we get 10,000 likes? And there wasn't like any reason. I was like, come on, it would just be a cool idea. Let's see if you guys can do it. And I click on the video now, a week later, and it's you broke it in 24 hours. You got to 10,000 likes in less than 24 hours of the video being up. And within, you know, the video, you know, going out, and now it's 6 days later, it's on 14,000. That's crazy. And not only that, like, because I'm not really this kind of guy who's like, let's see if we can shoot for so many likes. So I just thought it'd be fun if we did it. But in the next video, I mentioned it. I don't even know if I did. Like, I said something about, like, not knowing if you guys had hit it or not. But in that video, it's got 11,000 likes. And I made a joke about 20,000 likes. Let's go crazy! Like, about opening the Super Rare Plus packs. Sorry, I should put something on so, you know, you're not just listening to me yabber on. There you go, there's Indominus. Indominus is a good thing to look at. It's beautiful. As well as the Ford Explorer in the background there. Which doesn't have the glass roof on it, interestingly enough. So, I just want to say, like, I know it might be like something stupid. It's 10,000 likes, but it honestly does mean so much to me. The fact recently that we've blown up, I don't know whether it's like, I feel like we haven't literally blown up. We're still intact, but I mean, like, subscribers, views, and just overall like feeling on the channel when I go on it and I go on a video. I love scrolling through the comments, and it feels really good right now. Like, we're almost on a million. We've just found, like, depth, because I've had that game for ages, and I just never thought of playing it. And now we are, and you guys are really enjoying it, so I'm like, really excited to record that. It's nice to do something new and different. I just want to say thank you to you for being there and supporting me through this. It's cliche, and everybody says that. I know, I'm sorry, and I'm just like repeating what other people say, all the other YouTubers, but it's honest to God true, because I wouldn't be here without you, and it's you guys that push me to make better content and make something that you guys want to enjoy. I know that not every video I put out is something that maybe it's going to please 100% of the people all the time, because that's something you can't do. You can't impress 100% of people all the time. That's impossible. And I'll put out like Halo Wars or something that maybe only 10% of you will watch, but it's something I enjoy. And for those of you that do enjoy that sort of content, that's awesome. I just want to say thank you for giving me the freedom to sort of do this. And, you know, I don't feel like I'm obliged to make a Jurassic World the game video. This is the first time I've came back to make a video in probably about 5 days, which is the longest time that I haven't recorded a video, just because there's nothing going on. The only reason I wanted to make this kind of video, there you go, ooh.
Oh, I got more back, wow.
The main reason why I wanted to make this video was to say thank you for that support, because it's been a while, and I feel like maybe some of you guys were like, well, what was the point? Because, I mean, I never was like, you have to leave likes, but I thought it would be a fun thing to do, and even you guys smashed it instantly. 10,000 likes is a lot of likes for me anyway. Oh my god, I'm completely ranting. It's time to show Super Kool-Aid, yeah! Because Super Kool-Aid's awesome. And we get to see some, there's some dinosaurs actually that have cool idle animations that we never get to see. Oh, that's right. We'll put the mammoth on. The mammoth has some idle animations I haven't seen before. So we'll just stick it. Oh, God. There you go. So now I've completely lost my whole train of thought. but yeah, that was the main reason I wanted to make the video. I just wanted to say, I don't address it enough, and I feel like this is why I should do some sort of vlog or, you know, update, because I want to talk to you guys and get feedback, and also, in terms like this, say thank you for the stuff that you do. That it may not seem like a lot, leaving, like, I know you can only leave one like per person, but 10,000, that's crazy to think that there's that many. I know I'm going on and on, you'd be like, just goddamn play the video. But no, I need to say this because it means a lot to me. I see, like, loads of times every now and again that people leave comments saying how much I've affected their lives. In a good way, I hope. but the thing is, I don't go on about how much you've changed my life. And the little things like that honestly mean so much. And I wouldn't be here without you. I wouldn't be able to do the things I do without you guys, and that's why, like, us as YouTubers are so grateful, because without you, we wouldn't be here. And I know you say, oh, you make this awesome content, what have you, but the thing is, if you guys weren't watching it, we wouldn't be able to make that content. So yeah, this has been the first 10 minutes of Beaver. Skip over this bit, because somebody's gonna leave a comment, video starts here. I know it's you. Anyway. So let's get on with the video. What cool thing? Well, I'm gonna check the trade harbor because I haven't been getting any good trades recently, and I'm not trading a popcorn for food. Although I guess that kind of makes sense, but I'd rather trade it for DNA. So we are getting close. Well, not really. I think maybe there's only one more upgrade. There's probably more. I think you can probably have a max level of 10. I think it's about 1,000 a day for getting DNA or something like that. But that's right. I opened this pack, the VIP mystery, and got a legendary. I'll put up a screenshot because I couldn't believe it. I screenshotted it, and you can see, like, the other prizes are crap because they're, like, VIP prizes, like 30 bucks and 130 DNA or something like that. But there was a legendary. I can't remember what legendary was. I was just like, Jesus, a normal, well, VIP pack. And I clicked on it, and look, you have a chance of winning all the land dinosaurs, except for the tournaments, of course, in the VIP mystery. It's like, finally, they did something with the mystery pack. Like, the VIP, like, people pay for it. Hey, and I won a bloody, a legendary from it. So I was like, that's awesome. So let's do the free pack. Hopefully we'll get a legendary. Well, we got a rare, you know, 60 bucks ain't bad. Some coin, which is nothing really, because we're maxed up. And a tapiara. You can get that in a normal VIP pack, I think. So we're gonna collect some food. It has taken me ages to get, like, literally 2 weeks from 73 million to 79,000. I feel like it's been 2 to 3 weeks. And the thing is, I haven't touched the raptors. Not once. Haven't touched this because I know that I'm just gonna waste food on it and I'm not gonna get really much back for it. So we have a VIP only event. We have a What Lies Beneath, so the Ammonite again. Hold on a minute, that's a cave! I thought we were done cycling through. Were we not? What are we on now? Like, we did all the surface. So, oh, that's right, I think they did a vote. And people must have voted for Ammonite. It is Ammonite Shine. It does look awesome. But what we're here for is not the 40% off that. It is this, the Legendary Plus Pack. This was something that I was like, hell yeah! I want to see what's in this pack after the Super Rare Plus. Where we won a tournament creature. Let's see what's in this sort of pack. So we got tournaments in the last one. It's $48.99. And it seems like the same. Hopefully it doesn't glitch and break like the last pack did. So a Lycosaurus is... There is an Asaurus, but I think it's better. So I'm not too sure whether the Super Rare Plus pack had these. Because that glitched. Like, if you scrolled so far, the game would crash at about Megalodon. So, it's possible that the Super Rare Plus pack had all these two. Mosasaur, Secodontosaurus, Trudon, Dinocheris, all the legendaries. Segnosaurus, that's another one that hasn't been released yet. Kedrosaur was a WWE exclusive, although I think it's a tournament creature now. Which is kind of a shame. I mean, I donated to charity, which is awesome, but it would be nice to get something exclusive. And then you've got all of these. I was gonna say, don't tell me you can win, like, instead of a dinosaur, you win a bonfire! Imagine paying £48 for that, Jesus. So, the thing is, guys, I could spend 50 quid and get that, but I don't want to. What would be the chances? We'd probably get a T-Rex. For 50 quid? No thank you. What the best case scenario, and I mean the best case scenario, is we get something like Segnosaurus, Erlikosaurus, it likes to air lick. The Inosaurus, the Metrocanthosaurus, or the, everybody was leaving down in the comments, Yurt. Everybody wants to see Yurt, and I cannot wait for that tournament to come out. Yurtaranus. That's the best case scenario, and I'm paying 50 quid for one. And even then, I've got to do the tournament. So I'm basically paying 50 quid just to save on buying one. So there really isn't any point, which is a shame because I would love to do it. I would love to be like, you know what, this pack's worth it. But you'd have to give me a lot, Ludia. Yeah, you'd have to give me a lot for 50 quid for me to be happy. That's our overnight. Our overnight one. Now, I have been getting good trades. Now, the thing is, I don't like saying when something's good, because if I say something's good, then all of a sudden, it disappears from the game. And we saw it straight from the start, when I did the books versus, like, the buying the legendary pack, like, 50 quid on a legend pack, or 50 quid on books, and then we traded in the books for mystery packs and won so much better prizes than the legendary pack could ever have offered. And back then, legendary pack was crap. It gave you a legendary creature, but it gave you like 30 bucks and 20 DNA. It was so, so bad. And now it's like, you get loads for it. You get much better prizes. Or at least for your level, I don't know. I mean, I've been a level 75 for God knows how long. I don't know if maybe if you're a low level and you buy a legendary, if you still get like 120 DNA. Because that would suck. If you buy a legendary pack or win a legendary pack, it should always be 2,500 DNA, no matter what level you are, I think. So we're going to jump in and do the VIP-only event. And these ones, they get tough. Hold on. We need to put something in the hatchery first. That's right. So what I have been getting is a lot of Spinoraptors, and I've been trading them in. Like, I've just been working and working on the trade harbor. So we now have 11. And as you can see, it hasn't really hit my resources because I've been just getting them over and over and over, sort of popping in as often as I can, because the Spinoraptor, the trades I've been getting for the Spinoraptor, which are awesome, is coin, and so I've traded like, God, millions of coin every time I see it for a Spinoraptor, and I've got 11 of them now, and I'm trying to think like how much DNA that is. Like, if we go to our Spinoraptor, we've got 11, so we got level 30. We could hatch another 3 and get a level 40, or we could sell 11 of them for 44,000 DNA, which, when you think about it, isn't that much. And Carnoraptor gets a lot of coin over a short period of time, Quacker does. Because it's every 3 hours. And if you put them in, like, something like this area. If I'd probably trade out Unicorn Wizard. Because that's every 9 hours. So I might be tempted to do that. So who's the highest earner? It's probably Super Kool-Aid. Oh, no. I've already clicked on that. My bad. There you go. Up to 999. Well, it will be now. There you go. Right, let's jump in with this. Let's win a legendary pack and also a What Lies Beneath. Now, the What Lies Beneath will always be tough. Yes, I thought. Screw it, let's do this one first. That one. And you know what? Sod that. I think we could put in Scappers, that, and then that. Oh my God, that's going to be risky. Oh, we're dead in 2 hits. So we have to go for a block. Oh, Scappers. Please go for 2. Oh, you're looking for 1. No. Okay, okay. You know what, Sonic? Go for 2 reserve. Please tell me when... Oh, he didn't. Don't go for 3. Go for 1. Oh, yeah! Awesome! Okay, so 4 reserves and 1 block. Come on, guys. We can do this. This is good. Yeah, he blocked as well. He's gonna have 3. Go for... Oh, he's got 4! He went for 3. So he's got 1 block. Now, this is good. I think we've won at this point because we've got 8 and we can kill him in 3 hits. So we have to go for... We'll go for 4 attack, 4 reserves. So 1, 2, 3... He's dead. Factor in that 1 and then 4 reserves. Yeah! There you go. He did block. So he's only got 4. And he has to go for 3 hits to kill us. And that's a heavy investment. Ooh. Oh, he went for 2! Oh, 9 health! You beauty! He's only got, like, possibility of 2 block. So there you go. I factored in the 2. He did go for as well! Oh, pterodactylus, man! Awesome, at level 30, I'm so glad I got it. I can't... Oh, that's right, somebody commented saying, Beaver, you keep complaining about not knowing what to do with your VIP points. Why don't you spend them on the decorations pack and the buildings pack to get DNA and books? And I was like, hold on a minute. That's something we haven't checked. We haven't checked to see if, like, if I was to buy a building... Would you get good DNA out of it? So that's what we're going to do. We've got 173,000 of this. So we could buy 17 packs of the solid gold. I'm not too sure how much DNA you get in them. Or let's do this one, the Natural Science Center. Now, that again, that was like a WWE exclusive, which isn't now. Still 50,000 for Giant Orthocone. 8,000 for a freaking Paradise Lagoon. I love that the VIPs get special access to this. But really, it's like, oh, you get access to this new gourmet food. But it's twice the price. And it's basically the same. So this is 2,000. This is basically like winning a legendary pack. Like what you get out of it. So I'm expecting... What would I be happy with? 2,000 VIP points. Probably anything over 500 DNA. I think I'd be happy with. Okay, let's do this. So 2,000 of that. Whoa, 500 DNA. You know, that's... So if it costs 2,000 for 500 DNA, bear in mind we were probably lucky with that. And we get... Oh, and we get 80 VIP points back. Which ain't that much. So that was 2,000. It's almost 100. So 100 times 500, 5,000, 50,000, 500,000. No. Half a million. So let's say we got lucky there. Let's say every other pack we win 500 DNA. Then that's still 250,000 for 200,000. Is that better than what the trade harbors offer? 14,000 DNA. Oh no, that's the other way around. No, I definitely don't want to do that. Because we'll only win about, like, 2,000 DNA. So is it better to just do that? To win... How much for the rainforest? That's 4,000. So I'd expect maybe, you know, 500 DNA per thing? Yeah, 500 DNA. Double the prizes. Interesting. And, you know, we get more VIP points for that. What about a solid gold pack? So a solid gold pack... 2,000, 4,000, 6,000, 8,000, 10. So it should be, you know, 10 times... We should get 2,500 DNA from the solid gold pack. If we get anything less, you get more DNA and books, probably, in the Natural Science Center, in the building and decoration VIPs, rather than the solid gold. So I'm hoping for 2,500. Are you freaking serious? You get better DNA and prizes in this? Then I won more books in that. And you get VIP points back. So if I wanted to, I could just keep opening these. 250 DNA, 50 books, food. And this gives you better prizes than trading in VIP points at the trade harbor. So you can just keep doing this. And there's another 500. Oh my god. Guys. Huh. Leave in the comments letting me know if I should just trade in all of my VIP points for DNA. Having a million DNA when the glacier part comes out, we could probably just get all the creatures. But saying that, what if there's glacier... There will be. There'll be glacier VIP creatures when that comes out. So we'll do one more. And there you go. There's another 500 DNA. And, I mean, we do get some back. Spending 2,000 VIP points for 80 back is definitely not a good trade. You're probably better doing the solid gold, trading 10,000 and getting 1,300 back. At least, you know, it's like a tenth instead of the 1%, not even that. If you spend 2,220, 2,468, you get 4% of your VIP points back for buying the natural science, as opposed to buying the solid gold and getting 10% back. So, and then, don't get me started on the rainforest, because you only get like 130. So I don't even, 40, 80, it's like 3, you get 2%, sorry, you get 4% VIP points back for the science center, the building, and you get 3% back for the rainforest, and for the solid gold, you get just over 10% back. So if you want VIP points, solid gold's the way to go forward. And I definitely don't want to do this one. I don't even care what the prizes are. I think they'd probably be about like 5,000 DNA and 1,000 bucks. And that is not worth it. I'd rather spend 50,000 VIP points on the Natural Science Center. Doing it about 50 times. And probably getting 50 times 500 is about 5,000? Is that about the same? I don't know. Anyway, we spent way too long. We've run over loads of things, though. We're almost on this one. Almost winning it. Just two more. Who should we pick? This is a flyer. Ooh, we need flyers for this. So that, then that, then that. Ooh, that's intense. They're my besties. Well, not my best amphibian, because we got super Kool-Aid. But my best flyers. But Pterodactylus VIP can be bought back. Oh, that's good. So we can go for two block. Remember this tactic. Now, actually, somebody commented on the previous video. I think it was episode 250. That's when we opened the VIP packs. They said, Beaver, can you go over the fighting system? Now, there's a tactic to this. It's a secret tactic, but it's there. He's going to have... Oh, no, three. Okay, please attack for three. Go for three. Okay, went for two. We're going to switch out and then reserve. Now, you know about the exiting, if like putting in all attack, seeing what they've got, and then exiting. You guys know about that. But there's something even better. And I'll try to show you this in this video. He went for two. Oh, we're dead. Okay, he's got one block. Great. Well, you know, that's not bad. We kill him in three. We'd have to go for four. One, two, three, and an extra one. He didn't even go for it. God damn it, he's gonna kill me. He's gonna kill me. Yeah, I'm sorry. I have to do that. I have to do that. Please tell me it didn't. I think it's still gonna take back my go, hopefully. Because I need every block. Because that Indominus is gonna come in with five. No, I've got three, and it's gonna kill me. So I have to do that and then go for four. Otherwise I might lose, and I don't want to waste pucks. It might be cheating, but who's losing out here? Not me. I'm gaining. Oh, he's got six. Ah, balls. No, I could have went for four reserve. I'm an idiot. Oh, no. I didn't know that. Hold on. Now, this is the interesting bit. I think this is the glitch. Okay. Now, I went for four block, okay? Now, when you exit the game and you've went for blocks, the game forgets how many blocks you put in. Got it? Okay. So, this Indominus Rex knows it can kill me in two, But because I've exited and came back out, it forgot how many blocks I went for because I didn't go for any attack. And it thinks I've got nothing. So Indominus Rex will go for 2 attack instead of 6. So watch this. He's got 6. He thinks I've got nothing. He'll go for 2. And there you have it. Just by exiting, I survived. Now, how nuts is that? Now, let's see what he's got. He's went for a full-on 4 reserve. Right. Now, we can actually make this work in our favor. We're going to go for 2 block and 2 reserve. Because, like, normally, he'd go for 8 and he'd attack for, you know, 6 because we've only got 4. Now, we're dead. We're dead there. But if you exit out, the game, like I said, the game forgets how many blocks you've got. You come back in, he thinks you've got nothing, so he just goes for 2. And you've survived, as well as gained 2 extra reserves! Boom! So, to you guys, thank you for leaving that comment, because when you left that comment, I just worked this out myself. Even though it's been in the game for a long time, and people have said, Beaver, why don't you do, like, the block glitch within, like, Omega and stuff like that, and that way, you know, you can probably get more bucks and more DNA for winning. Well, DNA. So again, here we're gonna go for 2 block and 4 reserve, and then we wait till it's his go. That's what you have to do. He's gonna go for like 8-6, sorry, because well, actually, if we blocked all out, he wouldn't have killed us, which is strange, because he should have went for a full-on 8, and then he would have killed us no matter what. Now, because we exited out when it's his turn, it forgets what we've got. It goes for the lowest amount to kill us, which is 2, which we've blocked for. Now, instead of being dead, onto the dragon with 4, we're actually alive, and we've got 8! How crazy is that? Now, he had 2 extra. He had 6 left over after attacking, which means he's probably went for 2 block and 4 reserve. So we go for enough to kill him, factor in that 2 and then 3 reserve. And there you have it. Done. So instead of us being dead, down to our last, and he's got 2, he's down to his last. Now what we could have done there is done the same tactic. We could have went for 2 block and reserved. That would have been clever, actually, if we'd done that. And then the dragon, and then Pterodactylus would have survived. But he's only got 4 block, or a possibility of that. And there you go. So if you do this tactic, there's actually a way of not losing with any creature. And I think we should give that a shot with the next one. So what we'll do is we'll buy back Pterodactylus. Now, I never tried this before, but I'm confident that we can do this. You ready, guys? I'm confident we can do this. So, I'm going to go for 1 block here. I'm going to go for 1 block. He switches, which is predictable. That's good. Now, he attacks. So, what we do this time is we go for 2 block. We'll just get our goes up. Hopefully he attacks for 2 again. Now, this is what I'm wanting. Yes, okay. Now, I don't think... I think Pterodactylus is going to win this. Because we're going to do this glitch. So, 1 reserve, 2 block. Now, it's his go. And instead of, you know, waiting for him to choose something, we're just going to exit out straight away. Because if we exit out, then... he's going to forget what we've got. He's going to have 3 and go for 2 attack. Whereas we already have 2 block. And we'll survive it. And there you have it. I've just found out a way to win any battle with 1 really good creature. I don't think this would work with anything that's, you know, not too great. Because you need to be able to kill it within a couple of goes. And then have some goes left over to block and also reserve. So... we don't know what he went for. We know that 2 can kill us. So as long as we just go for 2 block, exit out when it's his go, we're alive. Every turn. So he's got 5. He's going to go for 2 attack. And what seems to be the case is they don't block when it's their go. So he's going to go for 2 attack. and then have three reserve. So what we want to do is we want to go for three attack, two block, and one reserve. So three attack, two block, and two reserve. Now, did he block? He didn't block. So, yeah, actually. This is interesting. So now it's his go. He has seven. Now, what's likely to happen there, if we let him, he's just going to go for seven and kill us straight out. But instead of letting him do that, we're going to be clever. Reset our reserves and blocks. He's going to think, oh, I can kill him in three. Whereas we have two block. Awesome. So again, we're going to go for two block, four reserves. Yeah, okay, this is it. This is how to win every match. Now, he's got eight. He went for seven, which means we're dead. But we're not going to let him do that. We're going to reset. So this tactic means that if they have any left over that doesn't fit into four reserve... So he went for three, which means he's got five. Which means he's going to go for four reserve and one block. So two hits kills him. Factor in that one. And then go for two block and three reserve. There you go! If you do this, they put as many goes into reserve. If they've got three, it's all in reserve. Two, all in reserve. If they've got five, it's four in reserve and one block. So he's got eight. He definitely would have killed us there. So we exit out. Reset. And wow, this way, not only do I save bucks buying back all my creatures, but also, well, that's it. And a full-on seven, because he put all of his goes into reserve and what little he had left into block. And there you go. We won with Pterodactylus, and that's all you needed. Pterodactylus can win every battle in this game. Level 40, a Pterodactylus, that is. 500? Ammonite, yes! Come join the team, you beautiful crustacean, you... Another 1,300 VIP points. On to our own VIP. Now, we don't need to do it for this, because they're pretty easy. We'll go for a Pelican Mimus, a T-Rex. Oh, good lord, I didn't see that Osteoporosaurus. Never mind. Carnoraptor. And... Ankylodocus, there we go. Probably a bit of an OP team. But, you know, Osteoporosaurus is going to be the first thing to come in. Oh no, it's not! Skeletor attacks! Meaning that he's very, very dead. So, there you go. There's a little tip and trick. Top tips from Zabiva. How to win every battle. That would be the clickbait title if I decided to do so. How to win every battle without fail. Oh dear. See, if I was somebody else, I might do that, but you know, every now and again, the thing is with clickbait, it has to be true. If I call something clickbait, if it's not in the video. So if you were to say in a Pokemon Go video, for example, first shiny catch ever, and there's no shinies, then I would say that's clickbait, because it's in the title, and that is not in the video anywhere. However, if it's in if a shiny Pokemon's in a thumbnail, for example, and it's not in the video, apart from maybe a picture that somebody throws up and say this is shiny whatever, I still consider that clickbait. And then this gets me onto my thumbnail of the baby T-Rexes saying we sell the babas. Now, was that clickbait? Sort of. I'm not going to deny that was sort of clickbait, but at the same time, I wanted to make a nice thumbnail. If you're watching my series, you know there's no babies. And I didn't say, new babies! So I don't consider that really clickbait. But if somebody does, I can see why. But if you know the game, you know there's not babies. If there was babies, I would just be like, new babies. And that would be it. I didn't say, there's babies. So I don't know why that stuck with me. Just somebody was like, this is clickbait. And I was like, because I didn't approach that thumbnail idea with the idea of it being clickbait. I was just like, oh, this would be a good looking thumbnail. And I usually write them all down on sticky notes. Like, if I've got an idea, I'll write down the thumbnail name and title and then draw a little picture. And that's what I did. So with this one, we've got Tiny Coolosaurus, which will probably switch out, and yeah, maybe a bit OP, but it's okay. I'm going to go for a reserve. He's probably going to switch, which means you're down a turn. You attacked! How dare you? Good thing is, I can kill you. Yeah. Whoosh! So we've won. That Gorgosaur's out, which means that this carnivore's gonna be killed. Oh, and he switches again. Oh, 900? Bloody. Good bloody Nora! I didn't realize it was gonna be that high of attack at level 30. 900? T Rex at level 40 has 600. VIPs, man, they go nuts. Look at that. Two hits. Okay, so we had three. So one, two, three, four, and then three reserve. Ready, and whoop-a! So yeah, like, the thing is, I feel like I've changed a lot in my videos, going from, like, because we're so close to a million, I kind of want to talk about, you know, the change that's happened over the last 2 years, almost. Because if you go back to my earlier videos, I was really, I wasn't open, and I wasn't really myself. I was still a bit nervous of putting myself out there on the internet, because there's, as well as there being a lot of cool people and nice people out there, like you guys, there's also a lot of people who want to shoot you down. As well as, you know, I don't think I was really that comfortable with myself. So, I think, like, maybe we'll do, like, watching my first few videos on, like, Jurassic Park Builder, because we did a video where we watched my first ever Let's Play, and I was probably way more confident and more comfortable with myself in that video than I was, like, starting the Gaming Beaver. Because back then, I didn't really care what people thought. I was just putting this thing out there. It wasn't going to be seen by many people, and that was about it. Whereas with the Gaming Beaver, like, Jurassic Park Builder started gaining traction. So it was like, oh, people are going to see this. You know, it's awesome, because, like, you guys like it, and there's going to be somebody out there that's like, oh, yeah, I want to see this. But at the same time, it comes with, also, there's people out there that they're all gonna see this. And I don't know if I'm comfortable with myself. Boosh! Yeah, we're still gonna kill him in one hit. Presta Sutures, if you were level 40, I'd love you. Hold on a minute! We did one solid gold pack, didn't we? And I completely forgot we won a Presta Sutures! I'm an idiot! Yes, we're good. I think that means we can get a level 30, because we have a level 20 and a level 10. Let's have a look, because a level 30 Presta would be awesome! Oh, he goes for five. Okay.
He's a proper Raji Himnik. Ah, knee prisoners. Raji Saurash.
Come on, Super Kool-Aid. Your T-Rex killer. Yeah, he kills it in two hits. Yeah, not a problem. Not a problem. Bam. And then in comes Indominus Rex. Come on, dude. What are you going to do? Do you think you're going to kill him? Oh, he's gonna give it a shot! I think he's gonna do it! No! If I went for one block, it could have happened. But look at this. You've got the old, best carnivore hybrid Indominus versus Prytrodon. Now look at them. There's 10 levels between them, but Prytrodon's only 200 and odd attack behind it. Health-wise, yeah, it's about, you know, 600. No, sorry, 900. Sorry, 700. 700 behind it. But, you know, when you hit that level 21, when you evolve your creature, its stats go up a lot in comparison. Like, the difference between a level 20 and a level 21 is a lot. So, Indominus is really not as good as Prytrodon. But who knows if... When we get Glacier Park, we get, you know, we get new Glacier creatures get put in. We'll get some, like, aquatic hybrids, and then some new hybrids for the land. And it'll all be hunky-dory. So, we're gonna do this again. The thing is with Pterodactylus, it's... oh my god! Oh, he attacked! Oh! No! god, cool! You were supposed to switch out for rage. Oh my god, he's going for it, isn't he? So he's gonna have like possibility of three. So what I should do is go for two and one reserve. I think that's what I should do. Okay, good, 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 good. Worst case scenario, hits me with three. Oh, or Rajastega comes in and he hits me with two. And he does. Now that's good. That's good. So we kill him in two. Ah, damn it. Okay. So this will be interesting. Now, do we let Gorgosuchus attack with four, or do we quit? I think we should just let him attack. Yeah, we'll let him attack with four. Now, good thing is... Oh, no, he still takes two to kill me. So what we're going to do is do this. And then when it's his go, depending on what he does... Okay, game over, we've lost. We've lost. That would have been it. We're dead. But, however, we've learned a sneaky little tactic, haven't we? And because, with his tactic, they always put whatever they've got left in reserve. That means that, we can easily kill. Whoa, 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 whoa! Hold the phone! Why did he still go for four? No! No, he should know he's got four. He should know not to kill me. Or did I do it too late? Why is he still go- Oh, we've lost. What the hell? Why did it not work that time then? Do you know what it is? I think it's because it's my last dinosaur. Yep. It's because it's my last dinosaur. That's it. Okay, fine. Right, if I had something after that, he wouldn't have done that. And I'll prove it to you. We'll put in Antarctica Pelta. Well, just watch. We're gonna do exactly the same again. And he would not have done that. He knew. I think the bot knew that it, like... I think there's a difference between... if you've got a last dinosaur and if there's something after it. And I think the bot just knows, like... I think it knows how many blocks you've put in. But for some odd reason, when you exit out, unless it's your last creature, it forgets. There's something in its code that's like... doesn't get it if you've got a dinosaur afterwards. So he went for a full-on two. So we can go for three blocks. Now he can kill me in two, which is great because I don't have to put many blocks in to survive. Whereas if it's a Gorgosuchus, I have to put in like three. So what we're going to do is put two block, two reserve. We'll see what he does. He goes for four, so we're dead. Now I'm wondering if it's a case of you have to exit before he's done his attacks. Let's see. If he goes for four, then that's the case. Let's work this out. No, see what I mean? But if Pterodactylus was my last dinosaur, he would have went for that and killed me. I don't get it. So, he's got... Oh, that's... Yeah, interesting. One, two, three kills it. And then... Let's go for two block, one reserve. Oh! Whoops! Interesting, okay. I didn't think he would go for a block. Okay, so we have to do that, and then two. Got it. Okay, we can still do this. So when his Gorgosuchus comes in, he's going to have five. Which is enough to kill me. He can go for a full-on five and kill me, which is probably what he's going to do. And he goes for four, which, strangely enough, doesn't kill me. Now, if we do this, it's going to forget, and I think it'll go for three. Oh, no! Interesting. Maybe three just barely leaves me alive, and four is enough to kill me. So... we'll go for this. We'll slowly work our way up. So, depending on what he does, he goes for four. Which actually would have been the same no matter what, I think. Oh no, because we're on low health. Sorry, this is probably sounding really confusing if you don't know what I'm doing here. But he's gonna go for 2 to kill me here. Yes. Yes. Now, if I didn't have Antarctic Pelter, he would have killed me. So, the good news is, 2 hits, that's all it takes to kill me. And, as long as we keep doing this glitch, he will consistently go for 2 hits. Now, he would have killed me there with that 4. I'd be dead. And if I had nothing after Pterodactylus, even if I did this, it wouldn't matter. He would still kill me. But because I have a creature after, it overrides its code into thinking like, oh no, I'll just forget. So he's got a possibility of 2 block. Wow, 2 hits, kill it. Interesting. So as long as we go for that, we can go for... Ooh, damn it. So as long as we have 2 block, we've survived. No matter how many attacks we go for, no matter how many reserves we go for, as long as we've got 2 block, we're alive. So that's that one dead. Now this next one will come in and... Actually, you know what? It doesn't even matter. But if he goes for 5, we're dead. Yeah, so he went for 5, we're dead. We're going to do this, we're going to exit out, and he's going to change. Now, I don't know why it's taken me this long to figure it out. It's probably because I've been doing the other glitch, which is like going for reserves and stuff. So he's going to go for 2. Yeah, he goes for 2. Now, so we've worked something out. If you are prepared and you are willing to do this sort of glitch, then make sure you've got more than one dinosaur, because it will kill you if you've only got one. So there you go. And on to the last one. Oh, look at all that DNA. Almost 610,000. Crazy. And so we have to put Pterodactylus in and then something, you know, that I guess... I don't know if it needs to be good or bad. Like, I'm not too sure. But we'll put something that's okay in for now. So he goes for 1. Okay. Right, now the good thing here is, hopefully, oh, I thought he'd go for reserve. What we want is to take enough damage that 1 or 2 hits kills us. That's what we want in an ideal world. So I'm going to go for 3. The possibility is that he has 5, so he has about 4 here. So hopefully he goes for a full-on 4 attack, because then at least we take a hit. No, he doesn't. Fantastic. 1, 2. It's probably going to take about 4 hits to kill me. So... we're gonna have to go for 4 block. I just want to get hit by 1. That's 1 or 2 would be perfect. That's all I want to get hit by. So that's great. If he reserves for that and he hits me with a 6, that's great. Yes, come on, hit me with a 6. Come on, do it. Oh, well, you know, that's good too. So at least 2 hits kill me now. Or not. 3 hits will still kill me. So that's actually not bad. We can take another hit as long as we do this glitch. Now, he's probably going to go for a full-on 5. But if we do this, he's going to go for 3, I think. Yes, he should go for 3. And if he goes for 3, then we're going to take 1 hit. And that means that'll push us below the 2-hit boundary to kill us. So now we die in 2 hits instead of 3. So we can only... If I can speak bloody English, I'll talk French now. Or Elvis Presley language. Now we only need to go for 2 block. Right, okay. So it's his go. If he goes for 4, we're dead. You know what I mean, right? Do you know what I mean? Like, how are the bots just somehow know how many blocks you've got? Well, this is the middle finger to them. You close that and go, no. You cheating liar. There you go. That's how many you should have put in. So now we have 8. So we can go for 1, 2, which kills him. And then all we need to do is put in 2. Now he had 2 extra, so 4 just in case. And then 2 reserve. And he did go for them. Boosh. And then all these Ostoposauruses are dead. So I can do... he'd probably go for 4 here just to be an arse. Yep. Would you look at that? Strange that. How he knew I had 2 block. Because if I better went for 4 block, he wouldn't have done it. He wouldn't have went for 4 attack. But either way, this is how you do it. You cheat him out and go for 2 block. And there you go. He'll go for 2. As long as you've got a dinosaur afterwards. This is awesome. I don't know. Instead of spending like 600 bucks on a battle, I just have to spend 200. So 2 hits kills him, factor in the 2, and then, you know, another 2. Interesting. Okay, so that's another one dead. You see, you can do this with any creature, but it's kind of, you got a chance, like, see, he went for 4 again, the exact right amount. But I guess it's because I only had 2, so we'll see. Now, it could be a coincidence. He may still go for 4. Let's have a look. No, okay. I was thinking maybe the bot knows how many turns I had overall. And it'll be like, well, it doesn't matter if you exit because I know you had 2 and I'm still going to go for 4. But that's not the case. So it looks like you have to have a second dinosaur in. You just have to. So he's got 6. He'll probably go for 4 again. Just watch. Well, it's strange that every time goes to the exact amount. Even though I had a possibility of going for 4 block. You're cheating, PC. I'm sticking it to you. So you've got 60. Strange that. Oh, you only go for 2 this time. All right. Well, we've got 6. And guess what? 2 can kill you. So suck me long beak. And that's it. We won a legendary pack. And you can do this for every battle. So technically, I don't have to buy back any creature. I can do this with Super Kool-Aid. I can do this with Indominus Rex. I can do this with Rajest. I'll never have to buy back a creature again. This is awesome! Yeah! So legendary pack, win 1,000 bucks, which well reimburses me for my Pterodon escapade. A modern arch, which I guess I can trade in the trade harbor, luckily, or else it would be a waste. And the Ostefricosaurus. As well as another 1,300 VIP points. So the common pack is these guys, but since I know this trick now, I'm going to do it in my own spare time. So guys, if you enjoyed this video, we've done a lot. We've shown that sort of way to win every battle almost. We've shown a way to get loads of bucks and DNA for your VIP points, if you want to trade them in as you wish, for the decoration pack. I think the building pack's probably more worth it because you open more packs and therefore have more of a chance to get DNA and bucks instead of coin or food. So if you're going to do that, I'd say the building pack. I was actually planning on opening the Legendary Plus pack, but there's nothing extra in it, even though it's got purple on it. Because I thought that, you know, that's the hybrid color. I thought maybe we'll win some hybrids. However, that's not the case. So I am not going to buy a pack. And again, I just want to say thank you for all the support you guys have given me over the last 2 years on the series and all the other videos I've done. It's been amazing. It's been an honor to give you these videos and to make them for you. I've thoroughly enjoyed. Wow, I sound like I'm retiring. I'm not. Don't worry. It's okay. And until next time, I'll see you later. Bye-bye.